Hi, my name is Bassam. I'm the founder of the Cyber Physical Mobility Group at the Chair of Embedded Software of RWTH Aachen University. I'm happy to present you today with the Cyber Physical Mobility Lab, an open source platform for networked and autonomous vehicles. First, I would like to use this opportunity to present you with my research group. It is named the same way as the lab, Cyber Physical Mobility. I established that group 3 years ago at the Chair of Embedded Software in the Computer Science Department of RWTH Aachen University. In this group, we focus on developing algorithms for networked and autonomous vehicles. Public organizations and commercial partners fund our projects. In the group, we focus on the intersection of 5 disciplines in mobility. Those are control engineering, mathematical optimization, and communications, which makes network control. Additionally, we develop a service-oriented software architecture, which can be used for implementing network control. Furthermore, in the field of network and autonomous vehicles, you always need to consider the perception system. We focus in this field on localization systems. Besides other single projects or projects with industrial partners, my group hosts 2 large projects. The CoinCar project, cooperatively interacting cars. This project is a large project funded by the German Research Association, DFG. Actually, it is a priority program hosting projects of partners throughout Germany. We conduct 2 sub-projects in this large project, where we focus on distributed decision-making and verification for trajectory planning of network vehicles. The second project I would like to mention here is Unica Agile. It is a large project funded by the German Federal Ministry of Education and Research, BMBF. And the project hosts partners throughout Germany. In this project, we focus on the research and implementation of a service-oriented software architecture for automotive purposes. I'm talking today about these 2 projects because they interact with the Cyber Physical Mobility Lab. For example, we test the algorithms and architecture developed within the projects in the lab. The Cyber Physical Mobility Lab itself is a group-wide project that makes our research results tangible and visualizes our research results, both for the scientific staff as well as for students. Before coming deep into details about the Cyber Physical Mobility Lab, I would like to motivate it using the project Distributed Decision Making and Verification. In this project, we develop methods for reducing computation time and communications for network trajectory planning. At the same time, our methods enhance feasibility and quality of control. The optimization-based applications we consider in this project are go-to formation and route intersections, which I will present in the next slides. Besides those, we look at applications for vehicle platooning or vehicle lane change, especially on motorways. And to be able to see these methods and applications in practice, we use the Cyber Physical Mobility Lab. Here we see 2 examples of network trajectory planning implemented by my group. On the left-hand side, we see an intersection where the task is to efficiently and safely guide network vehicles through an intersection. On the right-hand side, we see 2 different implementations of the application go-to formation. In this application, the task is to efficiently and safely guide vehicles from arbitrary starting positions to predefined goal positions Of course, the vehicles in these two applications are driving connected and autonomously. This video shows an exciting example of network trajectory planning. Here we see 8 vehicles running on the Hockenheimring. They have to compete to be as fast as possible, but at the same time, they have to cooperate to not collide with each other. The application with the two other applications showed 3 exciting examples of network trajectory planning, but they were in simulations. So it is more exciting to see these applications in reality. And this is the motivation for starting the Cyber Physical Mobility Lab. The aim behind the Cyber Physical Mobility Lab is to quickly see your ideas developing into reality, and at the same time, close the gap between simulations and real-world experiments. Our architecture enables the seamless use of the same software in simulations and in experiments without any further adaptations. In the lab, you can develop your algorithms in the lab simulation, test them, and quickly transfer them to experiments. I would suggest that you look at our website. The main feature of the Cyber Physical Mobility Lab is to be open source and remotely accessible. For the open source policy, we uploaded our code on GitHub, and we published our construction plans and documentation on our website. We have published 3 papers about the lab, and we are still working on other papers. The remote access via web is under construction. So stay tuned to this on our website. In the lab, it is possible to rapidly prototype algorithms. For this, we offer 20 network model scale vehicles, we call them MU cars, and a computation platform. The MU cars can be seamlessly extended by unlimited simulation or simulated vehicles. With a computation platform, it is possible to run software centralized on a main computer or distributed on different computers. The computers are associated to the vehicles. In the lab, we use an innovative software architecture. It is a hierarchical, service-oriented architecture. Service-oriented architectures are modular and easily updatable. We divide the system into 3 levels: a high level for complex computations, a mid and a low level. Our middleware allows distributed data exchange and synchronization of data. Now let us talk about the architecture of the lab. The lab consists of different modules. We constructed it modularly to be able to easily replace modules and to easily test single modules. In the lab, we follow the scheme Sense Plan Act. Additionally, we define an infrastructure part. The infrastructure part consists of a scenario server, a map, and a module which adds errors and noises to the signals to be as real as possible. The scenario server consists of a mission plan and simulation of passive traffic participants, for example, pedestrians. The scenario server sends the scenario, the static map, and the mission plan to the map. The map itself consists of 3 parts. It is hierarchically constructed. The static map consists of the route network. The dynamic map includes additionally traffic participants. And the preview map consists of data of predictions of traffic participants. The sense part consists of the sensors, which send sensor data to the perception module. The perception module computes object data and sends them to the map. The plan part consists of coordination, which couples the networked vehicles. The structure of the networked system is then saved in a coupling graph. The coupling graph is sent to the decision-making module, which consists of some further modules. These are routing, behavior, and trajectory. The control module belongs to the act part. The plans and states generated by the decision-making are sent to a verification module to be verified, for example, if they are feasible. The decision-making additionally sends the control inputs to the actuators, which run the control inputs on the vehicles. Now, I would like to talk about how we transform model-scale vehicles to network and autonomous vehicles. We use an off-the-shelf mechanical platform for the vehicles. It is designed to hold a servo motor for steering and a DC motor for driving its four wheels. So we extended this platform by installing an IMU and constructed an odometer. The LEDs on top of the vehicles are for the indoor positioning system. On the vehicle, we have a hierarchy of two computation units. We run mid-sized computations on a Raspberry Pi. The low-level microcontroller interfaces with the hardware. This animation shows how the vehicles are built up. Here we see the servo motor, the brushless DC motor, and the battery. This is the basic equipment, which we extend by a printed circuit board, which hosts the Raspberry Pi, the IMU, the Atmega microcontroller, and a motor driver. On top of that, we have a holder for the LEDs, which are used for determining the pose, which is the position and orientation of a vehicle, and are also used to communicate the ID of the vehicle. This also holds an additional board, which we see on the left. This is the odometer board, which hosts three Hall effect sensors. Those are shown closer here, where we have the magnet attached to the motor shaft and the three sensors. The indoor positioning system consists of the LEDs on each new car and a camera mounted on the siding. The camera has a top-down view on the track and streams images with 50 hertz. On the vehicle, the outer three LEDs form an equilateral triangle to encode the pose unambiguously. The center LED encodes the ID by flashing in a vehicle-dependent frequency. The camera records images with a low exposure time to have a high contrast of the light LEDs to the background. The IPS extracts the LED points on the image and transforms image coordinates to coordinates on the map. After filtering out noisy points, the IPS detects the vehicles and extracts their poses and IDs. In this video, we see 9 of the 20 new cars driving cooperatively on the lab plane, which is around 4 by 4.5 meters. The outer ring simulates a motorway, including access and exit routes. The motorway access and exit routes lead to or from the intersection. The vehicles implement here distributed model-based predictive controllers, MPCs, for trajectory planning. The distributed MPCs use here a priority scheme to coordinate the vehicles. That means to avoid collisions by adapting the speed profile. Note that the routes selected by the vehicles are completely random. This year, the RWTH Aachen University became 150 years old. We showed the lab in the celebrating movie. Look at our contribution. The lab should be open to everyone. I would like to invite you to contact us if you would like to implement algorithms in it. We are also working on an online course, so stay tuned to it on our websites. I would like to thank my group members and students for their great contributions to the lab. Finally, I would like to thank you for watching. Look at our websites and message us. We would be happy to read your comments. Bye-bye.